Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. My name is Coaster Chall, and welcome to Coaster Chall, the YouTube channel. Hello there, guys. Coaster Chall here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to this Coaster Chall Chats, bringing you the latest chats and interviews with people inside the theme park and attractions industry. Today, with a very, very special guest, the CEO of Fårup Sommerland is here. Niels, good morning. We're here to chat Fønix, the brand new roller coaster for the 2022 season. How are you?
Good morning. Good morning, Aaron. And thank you. We're great in the park. We are super excited about our new coaster project, which is going to be the biggest project ever in the history of the park. So it's super exciting to. Yeah, and now we can almost sense, you know, opening is approaching in April next year. So excited and happy. So all good.
Absolutely, mate. And let's start from the beginning, shall we? What made you want to come up with the idea of Fønix? What gave you the inspiration to come up with this brand new signature roller coaster for 2022?
For actually some years, it's been an idea to bring in an iconic attraction to Fårup Sommerland, to make sure we step or stay ahead of the game and in the game in the ongoing competition of attracting various guests to the park. And we've had a long and very successful history with Vekoma. They built our mine train in 92 and the suspended coaster in 2003, and latest they built the boomerang coaster in 2020. So we've had a super good cooperation and a good partnership, and it was pretty obvious that we should try to do something together. And then they brought the layout up for what's now called Fønix, and we were not in doubt, and we are not in doubt, that it's a great addition to the park that will help attract guests from both Denmark, but also from entire Scandinavia and Northern Europe. So, really excited.
Yeah, it definitely sounds exciting. And obviously the manufacturer of this coaster is the brilliant Vekoma, who've really been innovating their coaster designs over the last few years from the original prototypes. I mean, why choose Vekoma? Why was Vekoma the standout manufacturer? And was there any other manufacturers that you were considering before Vekoma was the ultimate choice?
You ask if there was other manufacturers in the picture. Obviously, yes, because in any case, it's really important to browse the market to see, okay, what could the alternatives be? So that's how we do in any coaster project. You could see, you could say that we of course look into different opportunities, but for different reasons, and not least also the layout and all the unique features we see with Fønix, the station fly through Denmark's highest and the world's first real stall loop, also being part of this this coaster. That was part of us deciding, okay, it has to be this this project, because it fulfills so many purposes and brings so much iconic value to a coaster experience, at least in our opinion. So, yeah
100%. And you know, obviously, the construction of the ride's been happening over the last few months. It's been a very rapid process compared to other coaster projects that have been constructed. You know, how pleased are you with how smooth the construction process has gone?
Considering it's a coaster founded on 170 foundations carrying this this coaster, then it's quite amazing that we started groundworks in February and now it's late November, and all the foundations have been done, and the track has been assembled, and the track is actually complete today. So it's been a super smooth process, and that's due to, you know, great partnership not only with Vekoma but also with RCS assembling the track, and also the construction company Venlust, a local partner. We have taken care of both the buildings and the foundation and groundworks. It's been super smooth and lucky enough for us. We haven't seen any big hiccups along the way.
Yeah, 100%. And it's great for the part there was no real massive hiccups during the construction process. Now, the name Fønix, what made you come to the decision about the name Fønix? Because obviously there's a lot of coasts out there that are called Fønix. What sort of made Fønix stand out for you, and why did you decide to go with that name?
In the park, we already carry bird names for some of our rides. We have Falcon, our wooden coaster, and we have other examples also across the park. And then, Fønix is more like an imaginary bird. But what really made us choose Fønix and why it was super obvious is that also considering the period we've been through now with the COVID-19 and all the obstructions we've been through, and also for us in 2020, a decrease in guest numbers, we kind of, come up from the ashes and now and choose to move on with investing in and building Fønix, despite it's been tough times for us as a park. So for those two reasons, both staying within using the bird names and also the symbolic thing about us trying to take a big step up with our park and hopefully we will see an increase in number of guests coming to the park.
Absolutely, and I love the. The story behind the name, and I love the sound of that, coming up from the ashes and also linking to the bird of prey. I love it. So talking about then the theming level, enthusiasts are going to be really excited about how much theming could be on this coaster. What can we expect from the level of theming and what kind of theming we're expecting to see on opening day?
To also, to match the DNA of the park and to do what we think we're good at. First of all, it will be nicely connected to the forest feeling. The construction company and everyone else that has worked around the construction site knows that we take care in every single tree. So every tree we have been able to keep, it's been kept. So you're going to get a nice forest feeling around the rides, first of all, and then secondly, we are working with different effects and elements and theming elements, where we of course put efforts into theming the station building. I can reveal that we're gonna do some big banners that's gonna be part of filling out this huge room where you have the fly through of the station, and then we try to tie the theming, of course, to the Fønix story. So I'm not yet ready to reveal all the details, but it's going to be a nice mix, with this forest feeling and then some elements connecting to the Fønix story.
100%, and I'm really excited to see all of that on opening day, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll be able to get to the park for the opening of this coaster, if not the media day, fingers crossed. Finally then, so I was moving aside from Fønix and talking about the future, because as you said, Fønix is like the signature attraction. It's the step up for Fårup Sommerland. Any teasers, action, any future projects or what we'd like to see come to the park?
It's not a secret that accommodation has been a great success for our park with our hotel. So that's absolutely an area of interest. And secondly, we have loads of ideas and things we wanna make come alive in the coming years. So I can't exactly tell you what we have in our minds, but. We also have great plans beyond Fønix, because a park like Fårup Sommerland and maybe any park, it's really a matter of ensuring that we develop the different experiences, and we have to come up with something new every year. And we're going to stick to that plan that, yeah, of course, we're going to have also new activities coming in the coming years.
Fantastic. Possibly ROC on the call. Let's get Rocky Mountain Construction on the park. Oh, it'd be nice if RMC got a coaster at the park. It'd be brilliant.
Yeah, yeah. Noted that one. Yeah.
Yes. There you go, fans. You heard it here first. Niels, thank you very, very much for coming on the show. It really does mean the world. Like I said, media day, public day, I'll be there. I'll try my best to get down there to Denmark. I really will.
Yeah. Look forward to see you, and great chatting to you, and look forward to see you. Yeah.
Thank you. And I hear you're a fan of the videos as well. You're a fan of what we do on Coaster Chall as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a great place, you know, to get some updates and also some of the rumors from our business. It's great to follow your different updates. So thanks for that. And, you know, you play a really important role for our industry also to be a person and having your YouTube set up, telling about what's going on in our business. It's just inspirational to follow one. So, yeah, thanks a lot.
No problem. And thank you guys for watching this very special video. I'll be back with more Coaster Chall Chats. You know I will. As well as more theme park newsroom updates as well. We've got lots coming on the channel in the next few weeks, so stay tuned for all that. Loads of exciting updates. But for now, I'm Coaster Chall. Keep living the coaster life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Fenix-tastic day.
Keep your head back. Hold on tight. You must escape.